In the second reading, St. Paul writes that the Lord Jesus, on the night he was handed over, took bread, and after he had given thanks, said, "This is my body that is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, he took the cup after the supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Do this in remembrance of me. This is what we do every time we gather for the Eucharist around this altar. On this Holy Thursday evening, we commemorate that supper, that first Eucharist, as we take bread and wine and do as he did. And we do this in memory of Jesus. What do we remember? Is it just words and actions, taking bread and wine and saying his words? Is it just the memory of the Last Supper? It's much, much more. It is remembering that he laid down his life for us, out of love for us, for our salvation. It is remembering his passion, death, and resurrection, Good Friday and Easter Sunday, his sacrifice which brings us life. And this memory is more than mere recollection, thinking of things past. This memory actually makes alive and present here and now the power of his death and resurrection. It's somewhat surprising that the gospel for this Holy Thursday Mass is not the account of the Last Supper itself, but when Jesus took bread and wine, it's a story that takes place before the meal, as Jesus and his disciples gathered. It's his washing the feet of his disciples. And in it, Jesus gives us a stunning lesson, one that shocked his disciples. He gives us a pattern to follow, to live up to. It's not something splashy or grand, nothing to shine a spotlight on. It's a very menial act done by a servant, washing feet. This is the model of humble service for us to imitate. Now, what's the connection between the Eucharist and humble service, our acts of charity and humility to other, washing feet? It's this: the gift we receive in our communion of the body and blood of Christ is lived out in our humble service, in acts big and small, acts of kindness, deeds of love, thinking about others, giving of ourselves. The Eucharist, the body of Christ, is not just for our consumption, our private consumption, looking for what I have, what I'm receiving, what I need and want. It's also for our giving, stretching out to others in love of them. Communion is not just for our taking, not just something given to me, between me and God, but it is for me in turn to give in charity and humble service, to give of my own life in charity and humble service. St. Augustine says something very powerful about this. He says, Christ gives us the meal on this altar, his body and blood, and he provides for it through his cross and resurrection. And then he says, as you partake of this meal on the altar, provide the same kind of meal yourselves for others. Provide the same kind of meal yourselves for others. The same kind of meal he's talking about is not the bread and wine on the altar, but our sacrifice of charity and humble service, laying down our lives in little and big ways out of love for others. In this time of the coronavirus pandemic, there are ways we can provide the same kind of meal to others. Things we can do easily, taking up the phone and reaching out, calling someone who may be lonely, or doing this on social media, praying for healthcare workers and first responders, praying for one another, staying at home and keeping social distancing, doing our part to stem the spread of this virus. Even though we cannot physically come to receive the body of Christ here at the altar tonight, we're still members of the body of Christ. The grace of the last time we received communion remains. You know, there's no expiration date on it, for it's nothing less than the love and life of Christ that we share. And we're still called to be Christ's for others, to provide the same kind of meal to others, and to do so in remembrance of Him. At this Holy Thursday Mass, we usually follow the homily by reenacting what Jesus did as He washed the feet of His disciples. But we're living in unusual times with the need for social distancing, and so we're not going to do this. What we're going to do is to see and reflect on the example Jesus gave us as it is lived out today in people who are risking their lives on the front lines as healthcare workers and first responders, or who are providing food and other essentials for us in this crisis. Theirs is humble service, as Jesus used the example of a household slave stooping to wash a feet. So now what these people do are examples for us today.
Where you as I have done.